coming to the agenda, how many servers in your company before Azure? They're asking something like that. Okay, how you can say the answer for us? For example, you are working in a big company or small company. Based on that, you have to say. For example, there is a company called some XYZ company that are working in Hyderabad or Chennai or somewhere else, more than 300 people. 300 people, more than some applications are there. You are working more than 300. Like that, in that case, you can say 30 servers. Something like production and development, QA, like that, we can say that. Before that, I am saying that. What are the servers we have? What are the servers you have? Like this, second question will be coming. Application servers, database servers, web servers, like that you can say. You have to prepare a structure. You have to prepare a structure based on your mentioned in your CV. Before whatever you have that. I can say, for example, if you are working in a middle level company, I can moreover 90 servers may be there. It's in data center, 90 or 100 like that. Okay. What are the servers? You can say development or testing, production like that. Production is coming to the live server. Okay. Based on your CV, you have to customize these things. Okay. Suppose I'm working in big MNC. Can I say like this? For example, I have been working in AstraZeneca past 5 years back. In that, how many servers are there? Somebody is asking. In that, I can say more than 2,000 servers are there in AstraZeneca Medical. 2,000 servers. Okay, we are handling that. How many DBAs are there? You know, DBAs or admins or whatever. 20 people are there. Every shift, they are coming 12 people. Based on your company, based on your client, you have to mention like that. Which technology you are using for virtual technology? Which before Azure, I am discussing. Azure, now we got it right. Before, what is that? You have to say to interviewer for second round mostly. First round, who will take the interviews? 4 years guy or 5 years guy. They won't ask these things. For example, 15 years, 10 years guys are sitting in your interview, second round or third round. These people will be asking. What platform you are using for virtual technologies? In my organization, we are using VMware. Mostly. Some companies are using Hyper-V. Some companies. Okay, your answering is I am using VMware. Okay, fine, no problem. You can say like that. Can I use Hyper-V? Yes, maybe some people will be based on the cost. Both VMs also they are using. Like this, you can say the answer for that. How you can migrate virtual machine to Azure machine? That is important. These type of questions you'll face in second round or maybe based on that I'm saying that I will tell you lot of questions are there. I will tell you every two questions or everything I will discuss. Keep on. How you can migrate? Can I migrate first of all a VM machine to Azure? Is it possible? No, it's not possible. Why? Means this file extension is different, that file extension is different. How you can do that then? With using Azure Site Recovery, you have to convert as an image, then you can do that. I'll explain in detail in another coming sessions. Okay. Now, third one. How you can secure your data while connecting from your local connector to with using Cisco? You can see here. See, we are using Cisco. With using Cisco, we have to connect to the servers. Whatever you VNet, whatever your theoretically is fine, but we are using third-party tools for connecting whatever you have to do. Okay. Later I will explain on how the network, how they are connecting, how they are using third-party tools for these things. Later I will let you know. And what is the daily activities? Coming to that. What is the daily activities of an Azure administrator? This is very important. What types you will get it? First of all, we Azure administrator, we should not say taking VMs or doing that, these things. That is not the process we need to follow that. There is a process called ITIL process. This process you have to follow. Like this, you have to mention first of all, based on the request, you have to do the activity. Maybe you will get a request called today VM creation. Yes, you can do that. Second day, you will get it a load balancer creation. Yes, based on the ITIL process, you have to take your requests. It's whether it is there, whatever monitoring and all those things are under, comes under ITIL process only. Fine. Like that, I'll give you detailed structure how to prepare whatever you are doing the daily activities coming videos. Okay. Like that, you have to say ITIL process, we have some sub these things also, incident management. Change management, problem management, transition, transition. Transition management. Like this, you have to do that. Change. You are doing some changes if you have been affecting something. Based on the whatever you know that technically we have. So many things are there. Whatever the things, you can say that. But moreover, we have to follow the process. Incident management, change management, problem management is very, very keen on. Daily activities. You will get a change request, service request. You have to do that. How many requests per day you will get it? That type of answers you have to say to the interviewer. Then only you can able to satisfy first level of that. Okay. Next class, I will tell you how to go with a question called, I will think and I will tell you that. You can see my video next video.